We are continuing to keep a close eye on 3i Atlas, a Manhattan-sized interstellar object believed to be a comet getting closer and closer to Earth. Take a look at the new images of the object appearing to have lost its tail. Some scientists now theorizing that this is a new indicator that 3i Atlas is no comet, but potentially an alien craft. Well, just under 6 weeks from now, it's set to get close to our planet, relatively speaking. And as several scramble for more answers, theoretical physicist and Harvard professor Avi Loeb called on NASA to release its new images of 3i Atlas. He shared this with us last week.
The best image was taken on October 2nd by the high-rise camera on board the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter. And unfortunately, the argument is because of the government shutdown, this data was never released. It doesn't make much sense for the politics of the day to sabotage the progress of science.
So what does this mean for all of us here on Earth? To help get some answers and some perspective, we are joined by world-renowned physicist Dr. Michio Kaku. He's co-founder of the String Field Theory, author of Quantum Supremacy, How the Quantum Computer Revolution Will Change Everything. Dr. Kaku, always a pleasure to see you. Thank you so much for being here. And let's jump right into this. I want to start with the new images of 3i Atlas, not from our own NASA. We are still waiting on those. These ones are out of Spain. Some are noting it looks like this object has lost its tail after passing the sun. What's your take here? And if there's no tail, does that mean this is indeed not a comet?
Well, I have my own point of view on this. And that is that this is a very old object, perhaps 7 billion years old. And in 7 billion years, there's been plenty of time to accumulate garbage. That's why, for example, the nickel content of the comet is off scale. Its chemical composition is not what an ordinary comet should be. And that, I think, is because over 7 billion years, it's had plenty of time to accumulate different gases, different elements, different kinds of environments that it goes into. And I think that explains a lot of the mystery behind the comet. And everyone's talking about it. I was on the airplane the other day and overheard some people talking over my shoulder. And sure enough, they were talking about the comet too.
Did you pop your head over the seat and say, "Hi, I'm Dr. Michio Kaku, one of the foremost experts on this, and this is my opinion"?
No, I did not say that, but I would gladly have given them my opinion.
Yeah.
It is a 7 billion year old comet, and that's why it's different. It's different from other comets. Comets in our solar system, for example, are maybe only 3 to 4 billion years old. This one is a very old comet, and as a consequence, it has plenty of time to accumulate garbage, and that's one of the characteristics of this comet. It has nickel, iron content, which is different from the average comet.
You know, we're still waiting on an updated image of this object from NASA. We see Representative Ana Paulina Luna sharing this week that it will not be shared until the government is reopened. Do you make anything of this? Is NASA hiding something here?
Sounds like it, right? I mean, what have they got to lose? I mean, it's only a sheet of paper. I mean, it's not like a top secret thing you put in a safe. It's just a sheet of paper. So what have they got to lose by announcing that they have this information? Because it fosters more and more speculation. And at a certain point, it becomes counterproductive.
You've been closely monitoring 3i Atlas for months now. I'm tracking these anomalies, some bizarre behavior. What are the odds that we're dealing with something not just old, but something that's extraterrestrial in nature?
I think it's non-zero, but it's very small. Hmm. So far, it looks like an ordinary comet. It behaves like an ordinary comet, and except for these a few anomalies, it does act like an ordinary comet. And so I think it's really pointless to preserve secrets to keep things away from the American public. The public want to know.
Avi Loeb, meanwhile, out of Harvard, believes that 3i Atlas may be revving its engine. Any thoughts on that?
Well, there's a possibility. You have to put probabilities with regards to all the speculation. Avi Loeb was very careful later on to say that the probability of his speculations are quite low. And so we have to put this into perspective that these are guesses, and as a consequence, they're not 100%.
3i Atlas has been added to the International Asteroid Warning Network to prepare Earth for a potential threat from beyond. We understand the object is going to get as close as 167 million miles away from Earth by December 19th. That is just weeks from now. Is there any reason for us to be concerned?
Personally, I don't think so. I think it's quite a distance away. We're not going to be invaded by aliens from a Hollywood movie set. So I think that it's harmless. It's so far away that we're not going to be endangered.
Yeah, Professor Avi Loeb has really been out in front of all of this, theorizing this could be extraterrestrial in nature. Perhaps this is a craft coming, doing some reconnaissance, just coming to check us out. What is your message to him? What do you have to say about his theories?
Well, speculation is fine, but you have to quantify it. You have to say that what is the level of confidence on the speculation. Is it 100%? Is it 1%? Otherwise, you panic the public. And the public wants to know the truth. Because afterwards, if it turns out it was a false alarm, then there's going to be a public backlash. People are going to say, what? We wasted all our efforts and there was no danger at all. So I think when you mention the dangers, you have to quantify it to say how realistic is this estimate.
I know that you warned if 3i Atlas picks up extra energy as it whips around the sun, that would mean in no uncertain terms that some intelligence is guiding it. Is there any indication some intelligence may be guiding this?
So far, no. However, there's been some speculation that it seems to be speeding up a little bit as it goes around the sun.
That's kind of concerning. I mean, the quote was that that intelligence would be there if it sped up around the sun, no? And it did.
To a slight degree, right. And however, there are reasons why it could happen. For example, maybe the comet broke a piece of it off. Maybe there was outgassing of the comet. There could be reasons that explain why there's a sudden spurt in velocity. So that's not a smoking gun. That doesn't nail it to the wall. It's just one condition that we would use to guide us into thinking that perhaps there's intelligent life there, but it's not definitive.
Yeah, what is the next thing that you are watching out for most closely then? What would be the smoking gun, nail it to the wall, other than, of course, it just landing? And like you said, some creatures crawling out from a Hollywood set.
Yeah, well, I think if E.T. phones home, that would clinch it right there.
Is there anything more scientific than that you'll be watching out for next in its trajectory?
Well, if they try to communicate with us, you know, some kind of Morse code, some kind of language that we would understand, some mathematical language, for example, that would clinch it. Rather than getting static on a radio, getting an alien civilization share their knowledge with us. That would nail it to the wall.
Yeah, one more question on this before we move to AI, because I understand there is a deep fake that you've been battling recently, and I want to hear more about that. Tell us what we need to know about this. It seems like there is a lot of speculation. It sounds like your message to the public is that they shouldn't be too concerned about this.
Well, you can just Google it. When you Google the name of the comet, there I am. I'm on several networks talking nonsense. And realize that it's very easy to forge these documents.
Oh, so we're talking about deep fakes now. Okay, so let's talk about this, Dr. Kaku. You yourself have been putting out warnings because deep fakes are happening of you. I believe that we might have some of them to show, impersonating you, AI generating this, misleading the public with false claims. And you say it's not just deep fakes that are out there right now. Countries are racing towards quantum computers. And that is the real risk going forward. Can you tell me more about that?
Yeah, it turns out that the PC that you have in front of you is digital. It computes with zeros and ones, zeros and ones. Quantum computers are way ahead of that. They compute with any number between zero and one. And how many numbers are there between zero and one? Infinite number. And so we see the power of a quantum computer that can break into any known digital computer. So who's worried about this? The CIA, the FBI, all intelligence agencies are on the alert. Because when it happens, 5, 10, 15 years from now, watch out.
Yeah, Dr. Kaku, does that mean that this could break into nuclear codes?
In principle, yes. Anything that is digital can be broken because digital codes work with zeros and ones, while quantum computers work with everything in between zero and one. And how many numbers are there between zero and one?
You're telling me infinite. Dr. Michio Kaku, I always appreciate you so much. This is a fascinating topic. I'm being told we're out of time, but thank you so much. Have a great evening.
My pleasure.